We're here today with Amy Andonian, who's the new president and CEO of Avanitas. So excited to have you. Welcome.
Thank you.
What was it about the position that first interested you?
Well, I've been in the field of aging now for a little over 8 years, and Avanitas was an organization that I learned about really early on in my career, and the community truly recognizes Avanitas as being a leader and pioneer in the field of aging. And I'd always thought that would be a great place to come and work, and never in my wildest dreams would have imagined that I'd be coming on board today as a CEO and president of the organization. So Avanitas has spent the last 40 years developing just some truly innovative and comprehensive programs and services for the community, and has truly innovated in different ways to meet the needs of older adults and caregivers, and is now poised to grow in new and exciting directions, and this is truly an inflection point for the agency, and really thrilled and honored to be at the helm.
Great. Well, I understand your position has been, your background has really been focused on aging, and tell us a little bit about that.
Yeah, so I am a Midwesterner. I came out here from Chicago a little over a decade ago to go to college at Stanford University, and I majored in human biology with a focus on gerontology and public health, and knew by my sophomore year that I wanted to pursue a career working in the nonprofit sector, particularly with older adults and their families. So after graduation, I joined Catholic Charities of Santa Clara County, and I oversaw their adult day programs and caregiver support programs. And I also was part of a team that started a new home care organization or program for the agency. And that program was able to generate fee-for-service revenue that we were able to reinvest back into the other programs and services that helped low-income seniors.
Wow, that's great.
So from there, I kind of just had this interest in social enterprise and had this opportunity with Institute on Aging to come on board, first as their Palo Alto site director and then as their VP of Home Care and Support Services. And I oversaw all of the agency's fee-for-service programs from Marin down to San Jose, and with that same bent of social enterprise and creating a revenue stream that you could generate in-house and then reinvest back into programs and services for the elderly. So.
Wow, your position's so nice to move into Avanitas and,
yes.
and lead them forward. What would be some of your objectives or goals for the agency?
So I am a big ideas person. I love to think outside the box and to be innovative and creative and entrepreneurial, and that's why I knew immediately that this was going to be a great fit for both me and Avanitas. And there's a lot happening right now in the field of aging that's new and exciting, and one of the trends that we're seeing unfold is this new intersection between aging and technology. And there's an effort to bring together designers and entrepreneurs and engineers and doctors and service providers with older adults and their families in the community to develop new tools and technologies to help older adults age in place for longer and with more success, and to also support their families with their caregiving journeys. So I think there's tons of partnership opportunities out there for organizations like Avanitas and Stanford and IDEO to kind of look at new ways to innovate within the field and create some new tools. So.
Wonderful, wonderful. I think one of the barriers we've seen in the past is that people wait a little too long to get help with aging concerns. What do you say to people about that?
For me, it comes back to education, and you're right, absolutely. I think so often older adults and their family members come looking for help when they're in crisis. And if you can get to them sooner and take more of a preventative approach of educating them about all the resources that are out there that are offered by both Avanitas but other service providers in the community, then they know where to go for help when they actually need the help. So it starts with education and just awareness of what is out there to help older adults as they age. And
super. I know people do look to Avanitas for that kind of resource. Now, on the personal side, what do you like to do outside of work?
So I have an amazing husband and two small children. I have a 5-year-old son named Taylor and a 3-year-old daughter named Alexa. So I pretty much spend every spare moment that I can with them, and love to do yoga. I recently picked up running. I can't say I'm very good at it, but it's a great cardio exercise for me. And we like to hike and camp and go to the ocean whenever we can. So.
Sounds wonderful. Well, Amy, we're just thrilled to have you in the community. If some members or participants wanted to give you some feedback or some thoughts on new directions, what might they do to reach out to you?
So we will actually be creating idea boxes, because I think getting back to ideas, I think some of the best ideas come from both staff and participants, and the staff in particular are on the ground every day working with these older adults and their families, and they truly know what the wants and needs are. So wanting to encourage them to come to us with those big ideas and, you know, to kind of have them feel ownership about the new direction that we're heading in and what we could be doing bigger and better. So.
Great. Well, thank you for spending time today, and we're looking forward to all the exciting new things you're going to bring to Alameda. Great.
Thanks,
Amy.